Dr. Paul Mason, Corruption of Polyunsaturated Fats Studies. The past few years has witnessed amazing new science by heroic researchers and doctors. Their findings help us to make clearer choices in our diet and exercise for stronger health, strength, and longevity. Here, Australian sports and exercise physician Dr. Mason shares the serious dangers of polyunsaturated fats.
So, you know, we're looking at the debate between saturated fat and polyunsaturated fat. Well, there's been more than 10 systematic reviews and meta-analyses on this topic, and they, on balance, they find in favour of saturated fat. So it was called the Sydney Diet Heart Study, and that ran between 1966 and 1973. And that was a randomised trial that looked at what happened when you replace saturated fat in the diet with polyunsaturated fat. But the problem was it took 40 years for the results to actually officially be published. That was simply because a research group in America actually went and tracked down the original study data and said, well, this was an important study, we should actually publish the findings and see, you know, not just publish piecemeal, cherry pick a little bit there. And when they finally published the results 40 years later, they found that those men who were given the polyunsaturated fat or the vegetable oil, they were 62% more likely to die than the men having saturated fat. Now, yesterday I received a phone call from somebody with very solid information, and what I was told, which is not public information, was that this study was actually sponsored by a very well-known margarine company. And the question is, does that explain why the results were not published for 40 years? And this is a blatant, I don't know if you call it a cover-up or what have you, but there's clear evidence in a large-scale randomised controlled trial of the harms of introducing polyunsaturated fat into the diet. And this is not an isolated incident. So the Minnesota Coronary Survey, which ran between 1968 to 1973, well, that was a double-blinded randomised controlled trial, super good quality, more than 9,000 men and women, again comparing saturated fat and polyunsaturated fat diets. So the study concluded in 1973 with the full results published in 2016. And what did that find? Well, that also found that, you know, taking polyunsaturated fats did lower cholesterol levels, but that also increased the risk of death. And then we have the Women's Health Initiative, which was a massive study. Over 48,000 females were randomised to a low-fat or a control group. And what that found is that the females who were put in the low-fat group, if they had a history of heart issues, then they had a 26% higher chance of cardiovascular complications, you know, meaning things like having a heart attack. And the problem is that even though this was a relative, you know, in the modern era, the result was not put in the conclusion. It wasn't published in the results table. It was never discussed in any of the numerous press conferences. Instead, it was buried in obscure text on page 661 of the publishing journal. If you pay $700 million to do a study, surely you must have a little bit of editorial competence there. I mean, this seems like it, given that there was only one statistically significant finding in the whole study, you would think that would be the most important finding to communicate. It would be hard to make a case that this was a simple oversight. This really poses a problem, though, for the public, because we're saying, well, the information, the scientific information coming out, the dietary advice is coming out, you have to question what's happening with fat, you have to question what's happening with salt. You even have to question when your doctor says you are or are not healthy based on, you know, your test results, you have to question the accuracy of that.
Summary. Sponsored scientific studies had the results hidden for decades. Results were ignored in government health guidelines. Results still ignored in health test parameters. Patients must do their own research to protect their health.